Hello everyone, and welcome to Mike Burr Thomas, episode 20. I've just come back to re-record the intro, and in fact, I'm going to leave the original intro. So, disregard what you're about to hear next, because I couldn't have been more wrong. Hello everyone, and welcome to the final episode of Mike Burr Thomas. At the end of episode 19, the agent in Mexico had just promised Lola that he would phone her back with the quote for hiring that helicopter. After Lola had spoken to them, of course, she messaged Denise. "I just spoke to Lola," Denise said to our man. "She's spoken to the company, but they're in Mexico. Could you get them to email me, please? Or better still, ask them to call me here on chat. Maybe ask them to email me the booking form, please." "Oh, okay, darling," he said. "Send me the email you want them to send it to, darling." "This one," she said. "I only have one email." "Oh, okay, darling. Let me know when you've contacted them so I can look for their email." "Oh, okay, darling. What are you doing apart from us talking now?" "Not much. What are you doing? I should finish the washing up." "I haven't had an email from them," she said about half an hour later. "Have you managed to contact them?" "Yes, darling," he said an hour later. "That's good. I'm just about to go to bed." "I have given them all the necessary information that they need, so they will send you the invoice, darling." "Okay," said Denise. "I have given them your email address, darling." "Okay, I'll look for an email from them." "I'm missing you, darling," he said. "I'm sure you are," said Denise. "I can't wait to always go to bed together. Also, wake up every morning together. I can't wait to give you goodnight kiss. I love you, darling." And so, our man's mate emailed Denise. And this is the invoice that they sent her. That company at the top, as far as I can tell, is a fish processing company in Baja California in Mexico. The quote is for flight duration 1 hour times two, total flight duration 2 hours, at a rate of £20,500, with sales tax, which is something we don't have in the UK, at 20%, £4,100. I believe they do have sales tax in Mexico, but it isn't 20%. And then underneath, they'd included the bank details of a money mule. They'd also, right at the bottom, included a UK mobile or VOIP phone number. Curious for an agency based in Mexico. The following morning started with Lola calling the agency because, of course, they hadn't phoned her back the previous night as promised.
"Hello. Good morning.
Hello.
Yes, hello. You said you would call me yesterday. You didn't."
"Yeah, sir, I'm so sorry. I think I sent the email to your mother, so I believe she might have told you everything."
"You said you would call me later, and you didn't."
"Yeah, I'm so sorry. I just think that the best. Yeah, I just think that the best way to handle it, because, you know, I thought maybe you might be busy, so I just had to send the email."
"What a baby! You promised me that you would call me. What company are you? Are you a serious company?"
I promised to call you to send the total estimate, which I know I didn't call you, but definitely I sent the estimate, because I didn't know how to..."
"Why didn't you call me as you promised? Why didn't you call me as you promised? That's my question."
"Oh, I'm so sorry about that. I just felt you might be busy. That's why."
"What about baby?"
"I said I felt you might be busy. That's why."
"I don't understand in English. Where are you from?"
"Oh, I said I thought you might be busy."
"Where are you from?"
"Huh.
Hello.
Necessary,
where are you from, my friend? You are the representative of this company. Where are you from?
Dear, I said that's not necessary.
It's very necessary because I'm the customer.
What?
The customer is the boss.
You are the customer. You are the customer. The only thing you ask, which I can give to you, is your information, not my information. My information.
I'm the customer, and I have to know who are you. Because you are the representative of this company, and I have to go to the bank to send the money. So tell me, where are you from? I don't understand your English.
Yeah, you just have to take whatsoever you understand, ma'am. I'm so sorry. Those informations are personal.
You can't tell me where are you from. It's so I don't ask you if you had sex last night. No, I'm asking you where are you from.
No,
it's a simple question.
Listen to me, ma'am. Those informations are personal. Do you get me?
Sir, don't be an idiot. You are the representative of the company. You are talking to me as an official person, if you know what I mean. An official person. You are not my friend here.
I understand you, and I listen to me, ma'am. I understand you, and I understand your personality, and I understand Mike Bertomers, and I respect him so very much. That's the same respect I'm giving to you, ma'am.
Okay, where are you from?
Okay, so I'm from Canada.
You are from Canada. Mm-hmm. You don't sound like a Canadian man.
Yeah, that's because I'm a mixed breed. You know, I wasn't born and brought up in Canada. But, Mark, I'm sorry I have told you where I'm from, and I'm not telling you anything else. Do you get me? Of course, those information I wasn't supposed to tell you, but in as much as you've known already, that's okay.
As a Canadian man, you don't have a Canadian accent.
It doesn't really matter.
Yeah, it matters because I want to know if this company is a serious one. That's why I'm asking.
Oh. Okay. Please.
No, you are silent now. You don't have the words with you. What a representative are you?
I respect your family personality so much.
Sir. Sir, am I talking to the cleaning guy? Do you clean toilets in the company? Just tell me.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I won't tolerate insult from you. I'm sorry.
No, it's not an insult, but I have to send the money, and I need to know if this company is a serious one.
Listen to me, ma'am. That's left for you to handle. It's not that. That's not my business. Do you get me? I'm only doing my job, and I have other people to attend to. There are other calls coming in, so I need to attend to other people. Please, I'm so sorry.
Okay, if you are sorry, then I will not go to the bank because you are very rude. You don't ask my questions. I'm the customer here.
I'm not being rude to you. I answered your question, but you are answering a question that's not necessary.
It's very necessary, sir, because I need to know. So, yes, it is. I'm the customer and I'm always right. And plus, I'm a woman, so I'm right. Even if I'm not right, I'm right. Okay? So, you must understand that because you are a man. You are a man.
That doesn't get the fact that you should just come here and insult a worker.
No, sir. No, sir. I'm just curious if you are the cleaning guy, that's all.
Oh, well, no, I am not.
So you are not the cleaning guy. You don't clean toilets. Okay. So What are you in this company? A manager?
I'm the company's representative.
Yeah, but what's your job there? A manager?
When it comes to do with the VIP and the VIP.
What are you there? A manager, assistant, secretary? Yeah, what are you?
I'm the assistant.
You are the assistant. Okay, I can see here the sum of 24,600 pounds. Is that right?
Yes, that's right, ma'am.
Okay, so tell me the airport from where to where.
Okay, so we're picking him from the sea and we're taking him to El close by Elipad.
Yeah, this
once he lands there,
this helicopter.
And once he gets to the destination, listen to me, ma'am, please. Once he gets to the helipad, we'll pick him from there and take him straight to a private place, and from there he can contact you, because for now they gave us some authorizations to not disclose his whereabouts. He understand until he's finally landed safely.
Okay, tell me this helicopter. Don't talk over me. This helicopter will take off from where? From which airport?
He's taking off from the sea. He's not taking off from airport. He's taking off from the sea. He's going straight to the sea to pick him and take him to the land.
From where this helicopter will fly, will take off? From where? Don't tell me that your helicopters are all in the sea. What?
That's the only information I can give to you.
No, sir, you have to give me... Sir, you have to give me all informations because I will pay a lot of money. So give me the right information.
I am sorry, ma'am. I was told not to disclose any of those informations or else it's going to cost me my job.
Sir, are you an idiot? It's about my money. It's about 24 pounds... It's about 24,600 pounds, a lot of money. And you are telling me that it's secret and you cannot tell me what I'm asking you?
Ma'am, I understand how you feel about this and I'm sorry. There are lots of people that pay 100,000.
Okay, so do business. Okay.
To them.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm not telling you your money you're paying is small or not.
Ah, it's small. Okay. If you are telling me that my money is small, I will not pay anything. Shut up, idiot. Tell your f***ing mic that I will not pay the money because you just said that my money is small. So if my money is small, do business with another client.
Listen to me, ma'am. I'm not saying, listen to what I'm saying. I'm not saying your money is small.
You just said it.
You. And I'll never say that.
So you just said it.
To anybody, because I don't want anything to happen to my job. If anything should happen to my job, I will hold you responsible for that.
You just said it. You just said it that my money is small. So if you consider that 24,600 pounds up when I'm speaking, idiot, I'm the customer here. If you are saying that 24,600 pounds, it's very small. So it's okay. I will not go and I will not pay for Mr. Mike. Tell Mr. Mike that, okay? Because you just said that it's very small and you don't need me as a client, as a customer.
I have no right to talk to him. You can talk to him. He's your family. The only right I have.
No, he's not my family. He's a f***ing idiot. Idiot, his friend with my mother-in-law. He's a f***ing idiot. He is not my family. But I'm doing this for my mother-in-law because she wants that. And she asked me to help her. Do you understand me?
I understand you, ma'am.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
Okay, if you are sorry and if you said that my money is so small, I will not pay any money because you just insulted me saying that 24,600 pounds is a very small sum. So do business with other customers who have a lot of money, not like me. Okay? Have a nice day.
Mom, do you do this too? Do you do this too? Mom, I'm sorry to ask this question. Do you do this to everybody?
What?
Do you always insult people this way?
No, only idiots. You are an idiot. That's why I'm insulting you. Because you are an idiot. And I don't think you work for that company. That company seems to be a very serious company. You are just a cleaning boy. You are just a cleaning boy from the toilets. You are cleaning toilets. You are not the manager. You are not the assistant. You are not. You are just a cleaning guy from the company. You clean toilets. And don't f*** with me, okay? Idiot! Because you told me that 24,600 pounds is a very small sum.
If you have a brother and someone treats him this way, how will you feel?
Go f*** yourself, idiot. Don't put me questions. Don't ask me questions. You are not in the position to ask me questions. You are in the position to answer my questions and you didn't. And plus, you said me that 24,600 pounds is a very small sum. If it's a very small sum, I will not go to the bank.
I was only trying to explain something to you. I was trying to explain to you that.
Don't explain that to a customer. I'm the customer here, idiot. I'm the customer here.
A lot of people do come to our organization.
Okay, do business with your clients, with a lot of people. Don't talk over me. Idiot! Bastard, don't talk over me never in your life, idiot. Tell your mic that I will not go to any bank. Okay? And I will talk to my mother-in-law and I will tell her that I will not go to any bank. Idiot! You!
Good morning, darling, said our man. After his mate had finished talking to Lola. Good morning. How was your night? Awful. How was yours? Mine was fine, darling. Can I have the website address for that company, please? Asked Denise. We agreed on Friday that you'd find a proper company with a website that I can look at. Yes, darling, he cried. And by now, it was Tuesday. He'd had 5 days, or 4 days, to make up a website. Their website? Is under maintenance, darling. That's why they've not given me the information as of yet. Did you receive the email from the company, darling? I did, said Denise. I will not pay anything. I repeat, I will not pay anything until I can see a proper website for a proper company. I think I made that very clear on Friday. Yes, darling, call me, said Denise. Okay, darling. Are you going to call? She said 5 minutes later. Yes, darling. I'm waiting, said Denise. And tried calling him. Please answer me, or call me yourself, she said. And so he called her.
Hello.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, darling. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you. Do you want to tell me what's really going on? I think I made it very clear on Friday that I want to see a website. I don't think I could have made it any clearer.
Yeah, that's why I told you that we have to get a little patient because they told me that the website is in maintenance right now.
No, darling, as I've said before, I realise you're a bit thick, but I made it very clear on Friday that I want to see a website.
And I told you that I'm going to give you the website because the website is currently down at the moment and they are doing maintenance on it. That's why.
Then you can still give me the website address so that I can see it when it comes back up.
Okay, no problem. I'm going to get that to you, okay?
Right. You do that. Now the next thing you can tell me is why a fish processing factory in Mexico is selling helicopter flights and has a UK phone number.
You said a fish processing company?
Yes, that's what you've given me the name of. They're a fish processing company, darling. On the Baja California.
You know something about companies, that most companies always operate on different things, you know? So I can tell us that's the safest way I can use to come, that's why, you know.
Well, I didn't understand the word of that. Why do they have a UK phone number?
Yeah, because they do operate everywhere. Like when they ask me, where am I going to, and my wife and my fiance and all that stuff, I told them that she's in the UK, and they have to contact you with the UK number, you know.
Right. Why did the man who spoke to Lola tell her that he was from Canada then?
Arnie, you know, working in a company, anyone can come from anywhere working in a company. Just like, for instance, just like I am, I'm from the United States and I do work in different countries, you know.
Right. If they have a UK phone number and they have somebody in the UK, I want an address. I want an invoice from their address in the UK with a UK bank account. I'm not paying a fish processing company in Mexico that doesn't have a website. I think I made that fairly clear before.
Arnie, let's not stress about
No,
this,
let's
okay?
not stress. Let you do what I told you to do on Friday, which was find me a reputable UK agency that books helicopters, that's got a proper UK phone number, a proper UK address and a proper UK business bank account.
Arnie, right, let me tell you something. Can you listen to me?
Go on,
please,
then.
Can you? Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah.
This is another tin pot company with some random employee on your oil rig, isn't it?
I told you about all the stress before now. That's why I'm getting the proper agency. And at the moment, they don't just allow any helicopter into the rig. It must come from a direct company, reliable, security, and all that stuff. You know, because safety and health is very important right here. So everybody have the process and protocols and rules that you must follow and abide to. So we have to be patient if you want the company, if you want to contact them on the website. You have to be patient. We have to be patient. And I'm trying to be patient right here, but the way we talked the other day, you wanted the phone number, you wanted the company name, you wanted the address, you want them to write you on emails. I've made everything straight and I've done everything. Just that you just need the website. That's it. I told you everything before now, honey. We're no longer kids. We can't be beating around the bush. We can't be stressing over little issues. Okay?
Where's your oil rig?
It's in Aberdeen.
Right. A company in Mexico will not be operating helicopters to an oil rig off the coast of Scotland. You need to find a proper, reliable helicopter company based in Scotland. Now tell me about this ridiculous rubbish that it says on their invoice. Flight duration, 1 hour. Where is it flying from and which oil rig are you on?
Arnie, I'm on the oil rig at the middle of the sea.
Yeah, which oil rig are you on?
The Gulf oil rig.
Right, what is the name of your oil rig?
That's what I just told you, the Gulf oil rig.
Right, it's called the Gulf, okay. Where will the helicopter be flying from?
The helicopter will be flying from the Scotland, from any city that's close to the rig.
No, it won't, darling. Darling, the invoice clearly says it's a 1 hour flight. Where will it be flying from?
Yes, you know, I haven't asked them where the helicopter will be coming from, but all I know that immediately everything is being done, the helicopter will be coming to take me and will be taking me to the nearest airport where I can take my
Where will the airport be? Which airport will it be taking you to? Stop being stupid, darling.
The airport that the helicopter will be taking me to.
Yes, which airport will the helicopter fly you to when it's picked you up from whatever you just said your oil rig is called?
I'll have to look that up, because it calculated 1 hour flight, so that means it will be very far, I guess.
Very far? What speed do you think helicopters fly at?
Honey, that's not my job.
How long did it take you to get to the oil rig when you first arrived?
Yeah, it took me 1 hour 47 minutes.
Right, and which helicopter company did you use then?
That's the company helicopter, because I didn't pay for nothing.
Right, well, if the company helicopter took you there free of charge, then it'll take you off free of charge, won't it?
No, honey.
Yes, darling. They wouldn't fly you onto the oil rig and just leave you there. They don't want to pay for you to be on the oil rig.
Remember what I told you, that I've paid long ago for everything. So when things got increased in price, it didn't affect me, because I've paid long ago for it. So
you've already paid. So you're now telling me you've already paid for your flight off the oil rig. Is that what you're saying? So you're trying to steal £24,000 from me when you've already paid for the flight off the oil rig?
Don't get me wrong.
Well, stop lying to me then.
You just told me
you paid for everything.
No, I just told you I've paid for going already. Don't get me wrong, please.
Then you can use the same company that took you there to take you off.
No, I can't, because right now I'm retired already. Remember that.
Exactly. So the company flew you on free of charge at the beginning of your contract, and they will fly you off free of charge at the end. They're not going to leave you on their oil rig forever, are they? Stop being ridiculously stupid, darling.
Remember when I told you that when the companies pay me for contracts, they paid me for transportation as well. I've received all my payments already.
Exactly. You've already been paid, and you've already paid for your flight off the oil rig, haven't you, darling? Now tell me something. Tell me about your accent. Where do you think you're from?
Remember I told you that I'm a German American, and I've worked with different.
Yeah. So tell me about your accent. Tell me about your accent. It's not American, is it, darling?
I've worked with different countries.
I'm not asking you where you've worked, darling. I'm asking you about your accent. You don't have an American accent, do you, darling?
I know I don't have an American accent.
What accent would you say you've got?
I told you it's a German-American accent.
It's a German accent. I find that very odd for somebody that doesn't speak a word of German.
You find that very hard, right?
Very odd for someone that doesn't speak German. When I spoke to you in German a couple of weeks ago, you had no idea what I was saying, did you?
No.
No, I didn't think you did. So you don't speak German, you haven't got a German accent, and you don't have an American accent. What kind of accent would you say you've got?
Arnie, I really can't tell you, because I'm not an accent detector.
You're not an accent detector, no. Well, unfortunately for you, I am. Would you like to try Lagos or Abuja?
What is that?
Yeah, you heard. I said, would you like to try Lagos or Abuja?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, yes, you do. You're an international businessman. You know perfectly well where Lagos is.
I don't know what are you talking about. What is Lagos? What are you talking about?
You're an international businessman with all those years of experience, and you don't know where Lagos is. Is that what you're telling me?
Yes, honey. I don't know where that place is. Where is that?
You don't know where that place is. I find that very unfortunate for an international businessman. Do you know where London is, darling?
Yes, I know where London is.
Yeah, what country
would you say? Lagos in London.
What country would you say London is the capital of?
You're London is the capital of the United Kingdom.
Awesome.
Right?
And what would you say is the capital of, I don't know, where else can I think of? What would you say is the capital of France? And I'll just interrupt myself here to save you all telling me, yes, I know Lagos isn't the capital of Nigeria. Come to that, what's the capital of Germany? You know, the place where you were brought up and the accent you've got. What's the capital of Germany? Oh, you've forgotten, have you?
I've not forgotten the capital. I'm just surprised at the question that you're asking.
The capital of Germany is Berlin.
Berlin. That's the capital of Germany.
Yeah, you've just Googled it. Congratulations. Well, now you can Google Lagos and it'll tell you where you are.
I'm on call with you right now. I can Google something.
Yeah, so now you can Google Lagos. It'll tell you where you are in case you've forgotten.
I'm on call with you. I can't do nothing. I can go on Google or nothing.
Of course you can, darling. How stupid do you think I am?
Honey, I'm on call with you and I can't Google anything because the screen is showing I'm talking to you.
Oh, darling, how stupid do you think I am? My grandsons can talk to me. They can Google things. They can look at Google Maps. They can do everything while they're talking to me. I may be an old lady, but I'm not that stupid, darling. Anyway, you don't need to Google Lagos. You know perfectly well where it is because that's where you are, isn't it?
I'm not in Lagos. I told you before. I don't know where the place is, honey.
Oh, well, I'm sick of all your lies. So telling me you don't even know where your own city is a bit unbelievable, really, isn't it, darling? A bit like telling me you're German, but you don't speak a word of German, and that you can't find a helicopter company based in Aberdeen that can actually come and fly you, but you've got all these ridiculous companies all over the world, including a fish processing factory in Mexico with a UK number and an employee who claims he's Canadian, but curiously enough also has an accent that sounds like he's in Lagos. That place you haven't heard of.
Darling, I hate being stressed out.
Oh dear, how sad.
Fighting.
Then you'd better go down and lie down in a darkened room because you're going to get even more stressed if you carry on talking to me. Because I don't like liars, you see, darling, and it's obvious that you're lying to me, isn't it?
Darling, I hate lying a lot.
Yeah, I know you hate it, but you do it anyway, don't you?
No, it's the situation. It's the situation on ground. I can't lie to you for anything.
Well, obviously you can, darling, because you are.
If you want my passport, you want anything from me.
Oh, yeah, go on.
All that stuff.
Oh, go on. That would be good fun. Send me your passport so I can see that.
Okay, you want me to send you my international passport, right?
Well, any passport will do, international or domestic.
Yeah, and I wanted to know if I should send you my international passport, my American passport, will you stop all this drama that you're acting right now?
Oh, yeah, I expect I'll be able to think of another drama instead. Go on, you send me your passport.
You think of another drama instead?
Oh, I'm sure I will, yes, darling.
So if I should send you my passport, you instruct Lola to go send on the 21,000 for the helicopter company.
Oh, it's come down to 21,000, has it? But will it keep coming down?
I don't know. That's what you told me. You told me the invoice that was given to you is 21,000, right?
Oh, did you? Oh, well, there you go. He's obviously trying to steal my money as well as you then, isn't he?
I can steal your money. I have more than enough for me to think of how to steal your money because that's a very little amount. I'm stressing the hell out of my cell phone right now. £21,000 is just a little amount of money that when I get there, I can give you money in double if you want.
I think you should, with interest as well.
I love you so much. That's why I'm facing all this stress right now.
I know you do, darling.
If not, I wouldn't have been going through this stress.
Yeah, you sent me a copy of your passport, Alan.
If I send a copy of my passport to you right now, will you instruct Lola to go to the bank right now to save all this drama and for her to send the money immediately?
Of course I will, darling. Of course I will.
Okay, that will be very good. I'm going to send you my passport. I want you to know I love you so much.
I know you do, darling.
And I share with you with my life.
I know you do, darling.
Thank you very much.
Okay, then.
Okay, honey. The invoice, what was the total amount that they gave you for the invoice?
Oh, I don't think that's any of your business. They sent it to me. I'm the one that's paying.
Okay, no problem. I'll try and scan my passport and send it to you right away.
Yeah, you do that, darling.
Yeah, you take care of your beautiful self for now.
I will.
Kiss, kiss.
I will do, darling. Bye for now. Excuse me. Bye for now.
Okay, bye for now, darling.
I want the proper contact details and address of this company's office in Scotland, please, said Denise when the call had ended. I want to know what kind of helicopter they'll be using, make and model, the name of the pilot and the airport it will be flying you to. I also want their web address, regardless of whether or not the site is under maintenance, and proper UK payment details. And I want to see your passport, please. A man sent her a copy of what he claimed was his passport. I've blurred out a lot of the details in case any other scammers find it and decide that they want to use it. He tried calling Denise a couple more times, but I was out. Are you there? He asked. I'm back, said Denise. Okay, darling. Where did you before, darling? I went to meet some friends for coffee, said Denise. Oh, okay, darling. Have you seen my passport now? You didn't say anything about it. It's a passport, said Denise. What do you want? Praise. I'm waiting for everything else. What is everything else you're talking about? He asked. So Denise copied and pasted what she'd said before. I want the proper contact details and address of the company's office in Scotland, please. I want to know what kind of helicopter they'll be using, make and model, the name of the pilot and the airport it'll be flying you to. I also want their web address, regardless of whether or not the site is under maintenance, and proper UK payment details. There, I copied and pasted it for you, she added. Oh, okay. I think, she continued, I made it 110% clear on Friday that I want the address of their website. I want a proper UK company with a proper website, a proper address, a proper UK phone number, landline, not some silly internet phone number, proper employee who knows which country he's in, which country he's from, and what his nationality is, with a proper UK business account, who can give me a proper invoice with proper details on. There's no way I'd allow Lola to pay that bit of ridiculous rubbish you sent. Why did you tell me this morning that you will give Lola the instructions to send the money to the company if I send you my international passport? Asked our hurt scammer. Because I hadn't studied that invoice properly, said Denise. I have now. Just tell me you don't want to do it, because I'm sick and tired of all this rubbish drama, he said. I hate stress. Oh dear, how sad, said Denise. Then you can explain to me why someone who was born in the USA, grew up in Germany, A, doesn't have a German or US accent, and B, can't speak German, oh, and C, has an accent from somewhere on a different continent. A man called Denise.
Hello, darling.
Yeah, hello, right, you've got a lot of explaining to do, haven't you?
Let me tell you something, because I've told you all this before. I don't know what's coming up right now. I told you how I spent my life since when I was a child. So I don't know how this is coming up right now, but I won't say much about it. Do you prefer Lola withdraw the cash and I ask the agency to provide someone to come and pick up the cash from Lola physically, face to face from Lola directly, and if you'll be there with Lola if you want?
No, darling, I made it 100%, in fact, 110% clear. I want a proper UK agency with a proper UK website address, proper UK business bank account, not some poxy fish processing plant in Mexico, not some person on your oil rig who runs a one-man band and claims he's an agency when he isn't. I want to know the name of the pilot. I want to know the company that you're getting the helicopter from. I want to know what kind of helicopter it is. I want to know where it's flying from. I want a proper invoice with all the proper details on from a proper UK company. And I know because you're a bit thick, darling, I need to say most of that twice. So I want a proper invoice from a proper UK company with all the proof
of details. You don't have to say that. You don't have to say that twice, okay? Let me tell you something. Listen to me. Here's what I just ask you. Do you want someone from the agency to come meet you and take the car from you physically? Then you can ask him all those questions, like the name of the pilot, because I don't work for the agency, so I can know the name of the pilot. So you can ask the person, the agent, when it comes to you to collect the cash from you, then before you give him the cash, you can ask him those questions.
Okay, apparently I do have to say it all twice. I want a proper UK agency, not a fish processing factory in Mexico. A proper UK agency with a proper UK address, with a proper UK business bank account and a proper UK landline phone number. And I will say that twice. A proper UK landline phone number. A proper invoice with all the proper details on, a proper UK address, not a fish processing plant in Mexico. Preferably someone in Scotland.
Can you listen to me? Because you're stressing the hell out of me right now. You're making me look like a kid, which I don't find funny right now. Can you please forget about everything? I don't want to come anymore because this is what you want, because you're stressing me with all this rubbish and bullshit right now. Don't worry, don't pay for my flights anymore, okay? Don't worry, you keep your money to yourself, can't be talking, okay? Because I'm sick and tired of all this rubbish you're talking about. I just told you something. Will you accept to withdraw the cash with you to that agent because I'm picking it up? Physically, face to face, you see the agent with your proper eyes and you talk to the agent properly. What's that you don't understand? Because I don't understand all these things you're talking about. You're stressing the hell out of me for the past 1 month and one month plus right now. I don't find it funny anymore.
No, it's not funny, darling, and you don't understand that I want a proper UK company with a proper UK address.
Right now, I'm telling you, a proper person, because I'm going to look for someone, a proper human being, if you don't understand me. I'm talking about a proper human being coming to you, talking to you face to face, so that you give him the cash and you can ask him all these questions that you're asking me, okay?
Don't be ridiculous, darling. Nobody hires a helicopter and pays in cash to somebody that comes to their house. At least grow up and try and say something sensible, darling.
You need to grow up and understand, because you're taking things too funny right now. You need to grow up and understand right now, because I'm talking to you since you want a proper person, you want a proper everything. That's what I'm telling you. That someone, a proper human being just like you and myself, a proper human being, we come to you to your address, where Lola will be there for if Lola have any questions to ask, you'll be there as well. You ask the question and give the person the cash for proper confirmation and everything.
Darling, I don't know how stupid I don't know how stupid you think I am. No reputable helicopter booking company sends somebody to collect cash, darling.
Yes, because that's what you want. The first time you ask the other company, that means so bullish, you can't collect the cash from someone else. You think about it. You think how you turning yourself around. You think about it.
Darling,
the last time you asked me so bully to come take the cash.
Darling,
right now I'm telling you, I'll talk to the company.
Shut up. That was £2,000 that was sent using MoneyGram. And the only way we could get the money back was to get the cash. I am not sending £24,000 in cash to some random man that turns up on my doorstep. Any reputable helicopter booking agency in Scotland will have a proper UK-based, probably a Scottish bank account, you know, Bank of Scotland business account, and they will expect people to pay either by direct transfer or using their credit card, darling. I don't know how stupid you think I am.
Darling, you talking of your opinion. Every company and everyone have the way to work. Everyone have the terms and conditions. Everyone have the way to do their own things. You don't talk how you doing your own things and expect everyone to go the way you doing your own things. You don't give people condition like that. It's a company.
Yes, darling, it's a company.
They have their own terms. They have their own rules to follow.
They don't send people out to collect large amounts of cash. Don't be ridiculous.
Can you listen to me? I'm telling you right now that this is the proper safest, and I know that my life is in safe place. This is the proper company that I'll be using to come.
Well, you won't
I'm telling you, I can talk to the company. They're going to send an agent to you. That's what I'm telling you. For you to be rest assured that everything is in good hands. I think you need someone physically to explain everything to you. Because you don't understand anything that I'm saying. You're just talking things to be done your own way, which cannot be so. I told you before, just like you told me, that you were working for a company, and I'm sure that your own company have their own rules and regulations, and you follow those rules and regulations. Someone outside can create rules for you to follow. That's stupidness and that's foolishness if you think that everything is being done correctly, because you want things being done your own way. That's not like that. You can't bring rules to someone else's company, because they have their own rules. You must know that, okay?
Have you finished, darling?
I finished.
Awesome. Excellent. Right. I know I have to repeat myself several times, so I'll just say what I said on Friday again. I want a proper UK-based company with a proper website, a proper UK bank account, proper UK contact details. I'm not giving cash to anybody that randomly turns up off the street. I want a proper company with a proper bank account. There's loads of them, darling. Even I can Google helicopter booking agencies in Scotland. I'm sure you find one.
I told you, just any helicopter cannot be allowed to just any rig. It has to be safe. It has to be secured. It has to pass 100 for the airline, just any company. And I'm telling you right now, you asked me to contact Canada for the helicopter, and that's what I did, and this is the proper way that you must follow. You must learn that a fishing company also travel different seas.
Yeah, and I
that's
it,
what you must learn. They also travel almost always to get their jobs done, and other companies also work. This is what you must know. I'm the man here, and I'm your husband to be. This is something that we must do with one heart, honey. We don't need to fight over it. If you really want to do it, then you must do what I ask you to do. Everything is in good hands, okay?
Darling, I'll say it once more. I don't believe that a Mexican fish processing plant has helicopters based in Scotland. That's the first thing. I made it very clear, and I'm not saying it again. You can stay on your bloody oil rig for the rest of your life, for all I care. Makes no difference to me. I want a proper UK-based agency with proper UK-based helicopters, preferably ones that are based in Scotland, so I don't have to pay for them to fly from Mexico to Scotland. God knows how long that would take for a helicopter.
No, they're not flying that far.
They're
not flying from Mexico to the UK. They're not flying from Mexico to Aberdeen. Okay? They're not flying that distance.
Right. Why does a fish processing plant in Mexico own helicopters in Scotland?
That's a business. You can own more than 5 businesses. You can own more than 10 businesses. You can own just one business.
Why does a fish processing plant in Mexico own helicopters in Scotland? Why can't you get a proper helicopter company from Scotland? There's loads of oil rigs. I'm sure there's lots of companies in Aberdeen that fly to and from the oil rigs all the time.
Honey, can you listen to me?
I've done nothing but listen to you, really, but go on, just for fun.
Just for fun, that's what you're saying. I don't think I have to talk anymore. You have a good day, okay?
Yeah, okay, I'm sure I will. I'll probably have a better day than you will, darling. Now, I see that you have making a fool out of me. he announced dramatically when the call was over. He tried calling her again, but he wouldn't speak. Every woman always listens to their husband and do what's best for them. I love you, and I know I love you. We don't have to fight over this issue. In reply to him saying, now I see that you have making a fool out of me, Denise said, no, you did that for yourself with all your lies. I don't lie because I hate lies. And in reply to him saying every woman always listens to their husband, Denise said, this is the UK, not Nigeria. Women don't have to obey their husbands. And in reply to him saying, I don't like lies because I hate lies, she said, obviously you don't hate them. Go away and annoy someone else. You're ghosted. Goodbye. Yes, he said, with understanding and same love. And then he called her again. So Denise, of course, instantly unghosted him once. Now what do you want?
Hello, darling.
Now what do you want?
What's it, what do I want?
Yeah, now what do you want? You feel a confession coming on, do you? You're terribly sorry, I've realised you're a Nigerian scammer and I need to forgive you. Is that the one?
Honey, this, what you're talking about right now, I just sent you my international passport.
Yeah, do you know the difference? Do you know the difference between a photoshopped international passport and a domestic passport?
Honey, I don't know any of that you're talking about. I want to tell you something right now.
Oh, I'm sure you do, darling.
And I want a proper understanding on the both of us.
Oh, right, I've got now. A proper understanding, darling. I know a Nigerian scammer when I meet one.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, do you not think it's very odd that you've got a Nigerian accent, you can't speak German, and you've been basically trying to scam me?
I want to tell you something right now.
I'm sure you do, darling. Tell me a story.
Shut up.
Tell me why you've got a Nigerian accent.
I don't know what you're talking about. I've heard about the country, but I don't know what you're talking about.
You've heard of Nigeria now, have you? Tell me why you've got a Nigerian accent.
You want me to call you on a video call?
Yeah, go on. But I want to see you. I want to see you, not a stolen video. I do know the difference between a real person talking to me and a stolen video.
You want to see me in a video call?
I want to see the real you, not a stolen video.
I'm not talking about a stolen video. I can steal someone else's video.
Good. Then I want to see the real you. Because I know you're Nigerian, yeah. So I will expect to see someone that looks Nigerian. Yeah, it's a
puzzle.
Why
are you making things so complicated
right
now?
It's a puzzle, isn't it? Well, it's not complicated to be who you are, is it, darling? I mean, you are Nigerian. What? We both know that.
I'm not.
Well, I think we both know that you are, darling, and you've certainly never been to Germany, have you? Because you don't speak a word of German.
Let me tell you something right now.
Oh, go on, another story. Go on.
I'm going to look for a way to get the website for a company, and I'm going to give you everything just for you to contact and do everything yourself.
No, you're not, darling. Okay. No, you're not. But you are gonna video call me and show me that you're Nigerian. Because I know you are. I mean, there's no point carrying on pretending that we're back. We both know you're Nigerian.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah, you've remembered
you've
where
got
Lagos
my international
is. Yeah.
Passport, and I call you on a video call. Yeah. And if I call you on a video call and you still joke with me, I promise you I'm not going to talk to you anymore.
Oh, that'll be good. Well, when you video call me, I will expect you to say, hello, Denise, when I ask you to. I will expect your lips to move in synchronisation with what you're saying. I will expect you to touch your nose and wave at me when I ask you to. Not when some random person in a stolen video does it. Do you understand that, darling? I'll say that twice, because I know I have to say everything twice. When you call me, I'll expect you to say, "Hello, Denise," when I ask you to. I'll expect your lips to move in sync with what you're saying. I'll expect you to wave at me when I ask you. And I'll expect you to look like a Nigerian man, because we both know that you are.
No problem, I'm going to call you, okay?
Awesome, go on then. And I will not show you myself until I've seen you, the real proper you.
You won't show me yourself, that's stupidness, you know?
No, not until I've seen the real proper you.
Yes, that's stupidness if you're not going to show me yourself.
No, not until I've seen, not until you've said, "Hello, Denise," when I ask you to, and waved at me when you ask me to. When I ask you to. If you can do those, I'll turn my camera on.
Which means you're fooling me. You're making a fool out of me.
No, darling, it's take it or leave it. I'm sick of all your excuses. I'm sick of all your lies. We both know you're Nigerian.
If I should be calling you a video call, you should be right there in the video as well.
No.
Not staying behind the camera.
Darling, I have made it perfectly clear. I'm so sick of having to repeat myself. I realise you haven't got very many brains between your ears, obviously. And I'm so sick of having to say everything three times. So I will say it once more, and once more only. When you call me, I will expect you to wave at me when I ask you to say hello, Denise, when I ask you to, and only when I've seen the real you, the real Nigerian you, will I turn on my camera. I'm not saying that again. You can take it or leave it. And I'm not interested in all your pathetic excuses and anything else. You can just say yes, you'll do it, or no, you won't.
Remember, yeah,
no, I'm not interested in pathetic excuses.
I want to tell you I want to tell you the risk which I told you the first time.
I'm not interested in your bloody risks either. You've got to shut up.
I'll call you on video call. Bye for now. You take care. I'll call you back.
No, you won't. I'll call you, said Denise when the call had ended. I can hardly wait to hear your excuses for not answering. So she tried calling him a few times. Unsurprisingly, he didn't answer. See, said Denise, I knew you'd be too much of a coward to answer. I'm going out again. Don't bother trying to call while I'm out. And so, of course, her man came up with his excuse. I need to get permission before making a video call. It's very risky. It can cause explosions. Don't talk ridiculous bollocks, said Denise. No one needs permission to make a video call in Lagos. You've been rumbled, pal. I know you're a lying, thieving Nigerian scammer. And as you've probably realised from the introduction, this is me coming back to edit the ending. I thought that was the end, but I was very, very wrong, because things were about to get much, much more interesting. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Mike Burr Thomas, and as I'm remaking the ending of this, I think I'm probably on episode 22 or episode 23. It will end soon, I promise you. If you've enjoyed this episode, please like it, please share it, please comment down below, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again in Mike Burr Thomas episode 21.